Good afternoon, my dear students. I am going to start the heat transfer session again. This is the third hour class I am continuing. Last class I was discussing about combined heat transfer mechanism. In many practicals situation, the heat transfer from surface takes place simultaneously in all the three modes of heat transfer. And the figure which I have given, which is having a boundary condition, that is a temperature boundary condition and convective heat transfer boundary condition. So this is the convective heat transfer boundary condition that I am taking here, and this is the temperature boundary condition. Okay. So here temperature boundary condition, and this is a convective heat transfer boundary condition, along with the radiation boundary condition also given. The assumption is made that a small plate is kept in an enclosure, shown in figure. So this is the small plate kept, and it radiates and also receives the heat. It may be in both the direction. This surface is also radiating, this surface is also radiating. It means they exchange heat between two surfaces by radiation. So this is the wall temperature, and it is air temperature is, it means away from the wall, whatever the temperature that we are measuring, it is treated as the ambient temperature. The simultaneous convection and radiation from plate takes place, and also the conduction from the base to the wall or base to the plate, that can be, it is having certain temperature already. How to write the energy balance equation at the point where I am pointing out the red point? How to write an energy balance equation at this? So the energy is received or energy may be emitted, may be equated by using the how much heat is transmitted from the surface to the surrounding, or the other way, it's from surrounding to the surface, by all the three modes of heat transfer, that can be taken by writing an equation, that is amount of heat given out by the small plate which is kept in an enclosure, that is QW, that is equated to convective heat transfer coefficient and the temperature difference of the wall and the ambient temperature, and the heat transfer by the radiation, it is the emissivity factor that is to be considered for the plate which is kept there, and also the Stefan-Boltzmann constant, and the temperature difference of wall and the surface. So usually the wall temperature is far, far less than the TW minus TS. If the second term can be linearized, we get, it means fourth power can be taken as a linear power. Linearizing means you have to take out the, because it is far, far less than your return, it means this fourth power unit is not required. Just to understand how the heat transfer equation can be written for this condition is, amount of heat transferred from the wall is equal to the convective heat transfer coefficient of a fluid which is surrounded by or surrounding enclosure, surrounded by the given plate, into the wall temperature minus air temperature. HR is the radiation coefficient, we call it as. HR is equal to fourth power, it means you are linearizing, you have to take this constant as 4 epsilon sigma T to the power of 3 that I have taken. So this is radiation. Or else you can directly substitute the temperature, you will get the same answer. This is to linearize the equation, that is how we have taken this. So this completes the how the combined heat transfer mechanism works. In many cases, in practical many cases, we are going to consider all the three cases together. This is the one best example. See, coming to the today class continuation, these are the some of the questions that unsolved problems I have given. the students who are interested to go through this, you can solve this problem. Answer is also given below that. You can take down and then solve, try to solve this problem and get the solution. So the coming to today class 17-2-2020 is the third class which I am going to present. So I am immediately switch on to general conduction equation. In your syllabus it is mentioned that general conduction equation for Cartesian coordinate, cylindrical coordinate and spherical coordinates. So here heat conduction equation, three dimensional heat conduction equation, Cartesian coordinate, I am trying to solve, derive an equation. How the equation can be derived by considering elemental volume having dimension dx, dy and dz at a distance xyz from the origin shown in figure. The general heat conduction equation can be written for an elemental volume from the first law of thermodynamics. You have to write the energy balance equation from the first law of thermodynamics, net heat conducted in x, y, z direction for unit time plus the heat generated internally in the volume element is equal to the increase of internal energy in the volume element. That is what the energy balance equation. Quickly come back to this. You consider this is the elemental volume I taken having dx in x direction, dz in the z direction and dy in the y direction. So dx, dy, dz are the three different, it means this is the three dimensional elemental coordinate that I am going to consider in Cartesian, and the amount of heat conducted in x direction, that is qx at x is equal to 0 and qx plus dx, okay, this is after the, when it is coming out in the x direction, this is the one phase. It means already Fourier's law of thermal conduction says that the heat is conducted through the surface, that is directly proportional to the surface exposed, normal to the direction of heat flow, into the coefficient of constant, that is K, conductivity K. That is the, so the Qx is normal to the phase, which is the area of this phase. It means the dx, dz and dy is the area exposed, normal to the direction of heat flow, Qx. In the x direction, the area exposed is delta y, delta z. And when it is going, the heat is going out normal to the surface, going out at the normal to the surface, again area exposed is dy and dz. So this is the elemental volume taken for the heat transfer, three-dimensional heat conduction equation derivation. Consider unit area through which the heat is flowing, that is unit area is dy and dz in the x direction at a given time delta t. It means you have to, delta t is a small incremental time that you have to consider. So the equation that I am going to write in the qx, what is the heat coming in x direction at the unit area exposed when the x is equal to 0, okay, it is minus kx, okay, delta t, del t, most of the same are calling as daba, delta t by delta x into delta t. It means there is a difference between temperature, delta temperature divided by the distance dx multiplied by the time factor here. It means in a small time, how much is the heat is transferred. So now come back to the previous slide. See, in an incremental distance of del x, okay, what will be the change of heat content in the system? When it is going out, what will be the change in the internal energy of the system? That we are going to differentiate with respect to x in the direction x. That is qx plus dx. It means qx is the minus kx dt by dx. This is the equation. Okay. And the incremental value d by dx of minus kx delta t by delta x multiplied by the delta x. It means the delta x is the change in the length of the element. So from one face to the left to right, it is heat is flowing. This is what the equation you have to write. So the amount of heat stored in the system, amount of heat stored in the system is calculated as qx minus of qx plus dx. As already pointed out from the energy balance equation, that qx minus of qx plus dx, it means that this two factors going to be get cancelled, only left with only this factor. So that is delta by delta x into kx minus sign. Why I am taking out minus sign can be written as positive also, because there is no significance what direction it is going. It is in the decreasing direction. When it is decreasing direction, you can take as minus. Heat stored in a time delta t per unit area due to the conduction in the x direction will be written as kx and dt by dx and delta x into dt. As the area stored along x direction is, which is the area stored in the x direction is delta y into delta z. So that the total heat stored in time delta t can be given like this. It means you have to consider the area exposed. You will see this is the conduction equation. There is no area. Ka delta t you are going to take. Ka dt by dx or delta t by delta x multiplied by the area. That is actually it is dx dy. Oh my god. So this become actually dy, one more dy is there. It is actually dx dz, dx dy dz, and this dx dy dz also in multiplied by delta t. It means dx dt already it is there. On the area is a dy dz. It's supposed to be dy dz. Please note it while typing, there is wrongly connected. This is the area multiplied by this distance, this become the volume. Okay, similarly heat stored in the due to the heat flow along y and z direction in time delta t in x direction, similar way in y direction, how you are doing in x direction, similarly you have to continue in the y direction. Again here one more mistake is there. Instead of dy you can take it as dz, and in the x direction this is kx and ky, that's going to be changed, delta t by delta y multiplied by delta x. This is the partially, what you are doing is the incremental changes are partially differentiated the equation. Incremental changes always you have to do it like this only. Partially you have to differentiate the amount of heat stored in the given volume that you get. Similarly in the z direction also, all the three equation 2.4, 2.5 and 2.6, if the body is generating heat, and is the heat generated rate per volume of a material per unit time, then the generated in the body is taken at the end of time delta t. That is you will mark it as q dot. So that I am going to take it in the next subsequent equation. That is amount of heat generated is q dot. It means how do you account for heat generated? It means there is some heating coil inside, and taking up energy from outside is going to generate heat. How do you account for this? It is the area again, or else you can volume multiply volume into time into heat generated. Therefore, the total heat which is stored in the body will be utilized for increasing the temperature of the body. It means amount of heat stored means whatever the energy store is stored in the example is I'm going to give the iron box. You are internally you are generating energy and also it is getting conducted out. So the cursor which I am moving, the red cursor which I am moving on the board. So this is the amount of increase in the internal energy. Increase in the internal energy because of heat generation. Okay, this is the internal energy rise. That is MCP delta T. You are already familiar with MCP delta T. Mass multiplied by density is equal to the volume. It means mass density delta, sorry, sigma into the volume gives the mass. Cp value is the specific heat at constant volume. That is, and dt, the time. So that we are going to consider. And time is very incremental. In small time, you are going to calculate this rise in the internal energy, substituting all this equation in the energy balance equation. So this is the heat conducted in x direction. This is the heat conducted in y direction. This is the heat conducted in z direction. Plus the amount of heat internally generated is equal to the, it means internally generated is by heating. So wherever delta y two times is there, you can add dz, delta z. Okay. Here it is, the amount of change in the internal energy. So that is equated. So now, for the isotropic material, isotropic means the material remains constant, it is not a different material. The conductivity of the material remains same. Therefore, in x direction, whatever the material property in x direction, it continues to exist in the same property in the y direction as well as in the z direction. That is equated to thermal conductivity of the material because it's isotropic material. The above equation can be written in this format by cancelling all this, the volume element, this one, and get cancelled with this, and this get cancelled with this. Here also you got, actually it is delta x, delta y, delta z. It means it is a controlling differential equation already written here. And this is delta y, delta z, and delta x. This is the volume with incremental time. That's going to be this get cancelled with this and this get cancelled with this. You take the common factor and then cancel all those things. So after simplification, you will get equation delta by delta x into kx into delta t by delta x plus delta by delta y ky, and the equation continues like this, plus the amount of heat generated is equal to the amount of change in the internal energy. Internal energy is MCP delta T taken here. It's supposed to be in the previous equation, that also be taken here. Here also we have to take. Okay. So that way if you put, you get the change of internal energy. So this should be multiplied by time factor because delta T is there, that is taken to the right side, and you will get the delta T by double T by delta T is a change. And finally, the equation that I am going to write by taking the constant k, because ky, kz and kx are equal to k only, by substituting that value and taking a common factor and then dividing it by this equation, you will get this. Okay, where delta T, time tends to 0, then the controlling differential equation becomes like this. So this is called the equation, a three-dimensional conduction equation with heat generation. This is the unsteady state three-dimensional conduction equation in three dimension. Why the unsteady state? You call it as time is there. When the time is there, system cannot be a steady one because you are counting continuously, you are monitoring, system keep on changing. This is unsteady state condition. If this factor is not there, then it is a steady state heat conduction with heat generation because Q dot is there. If these two components are not there, then only get three-dimensional steady state heat conduction equation. So this can be represented, alpha can be represented by, again you're writing, alpha is the thermal diffusivity. rho Cp by K is thermal conductivity by thermal capacity. So this way you are going to simplify this. Finally, we are going to take all this definition, and you already studied in mathematics that the Poisson's equation, controlling differential equation become this. This is the Poisson's equation, and this is the diffusivity, is the ratio of, first you'll have to take the definition of diffusivity. Diffusivity is the ratio of thermal conductivity to thermal capacity. If the heat flow is steady without heat generation, then the controlling differential equation become like this, okay? And if the steady state heat conduction equation with heat generation you're calling, then it is a Poisson's equation. So this is the, in absence of heat source without heat generation, the controlling differential equation becomes like this. There is no heat source, then this is called a diffusion equation. If the temperature varies in the x direction, steady state without heat generation, then the controlling differential equation is called one dimensional steady state heat conduction equation. So this is the one dimensional steady state heat conduction equation. Quickly I go back and once again I'll refresh myself. So there is only a change, there is by typographical error is there. So here I marked dy, dz and dx clearly I marked, but while writing the equation here also written clearly. Here one change is there, commonly I copied and pasted it, and instead of dy you have to have this as a dx. And considering the elemental volume, how the heat is going to be incremented from one phase to the other phase, and you'll have to, even it is getting incremented, you have to partially have to differentiate the equation given in x direction, in y direction, in z direction. Then with addition of heat generating component in the elemental volume, this is the equation I'm going to write, and total heat which is stored will be utilized for increasing the temperature internal energy of the body, that is rho Cp delta dt by delta T. And substituting these two in the equation, you will get this equation. Dt is missing there, that you will have to compensate here. Okay, there are two mistakes which are observed in this equation while typing, and that should be taken care when here it is the whatever the equation which are written, it's okay. And coming to the thermal diffusivity, see, thermal conductivity by ratio of thermal conductivity by thermal capacity is called thermal diffusivity. It's going to be very useful while solving convective heat transfer when you take up that topic of discussion. So there are three equations here. This is the three-dimensional conduction equation with the steady state condition. Okay. Go to the next. So generally, in Cartesian coordinate is very easy to derive an equation like this. But whereas in the cylindrical coordinate and spherical coordinate, it's very difficult to derive equation by using the method which I adapted in Cartesian coordinate. So for that, I devised one simple equation to remember and understand by using your mathematical tool, that is from the mathematics you have already studied, general three-dimensional conduction equation in Cartesian coordinate, by assuming the coordinates as delta x1 h1 is equal to h1, delta x2 is equal to h2, delta x3 is equal to h3. This is the general equation for curvilinear coordinate system with the gradient divergent and unit terms of x1, x2, x3 as obtained. So this is the, you consider it as a scalar quantity, and a general equation for curvilinear coordinate system with the gradient divergence of, this is the gradient divergence of unit x1 x2 and x3. Those things are marked here as the delta x1, delta x2 and delta x3 in x, z direction, x1, x2 and x3. These are the Cartesian coordinate system. To write an equation, let T be the, again the Krenner coordinate system again appropriately marked with the vectors, arbitrary vectors. So, well, let T is the arbitrary scalar and H is the arbitrary vector with the components of components in the direction of x1, similarly in x2 and similarly in x3, where T is the arbitrary scalar. What is that T is called? T represents the temperature grid. Temperature flows in three different directions, and where H is the arbitrary vector with the components in x1 direction, x2 and x3 directions. For that, general equation for curvilinear coordinate system can be written as, this is del square T. Usually delta can be written as, which I am going to write right in the board, you are calling this as a delta, capital delta you call it as, this is small delta. So the this capital delta, if it is this is delta, delta, if it is written in reverse, then it is, I will specify this as applied. It means del, usually mathematical teachers use del square T. I'll take it as applied square T, because that is ulta. I am reading this in the reverse direction. That is why I can write applied. So this is the equation already studied in curvilinear coordinate system in three dimensional. The general three-dimensional Cartesian coordinate with arbitrary scalar T and arbitrary vector H can be written as 1 by of H1, H2, H3, H1, H2, H3. This is multiplied by dabba by dabba X multiplied by H1. How to remember this writing that? H1, H2, H3, double T by double X. This is one component. H2 multiplied by H3, because one is there, I can use that. And here the coordinates are X1, here also X1, plus double by double X2 multiplied by H1, H3 by H2, dabba T by dabba X2. Next, plus of dabba by dabba X3 multiplied by H2, H1 divided by H3 multiplied by dabba T by dabba X3. You have to practice to write this equation. It's very simple. Only the one coordinate, second coordinate and third coordinate, I am going to plot them with the differential equations. Whatever the equation that you derived according to this only, it means heat transfer is full of mathematics only. The equation 2. Above equation, you call it as. The above equation is 2.16, and this can be the equation in general three-dimensional Cartesian coordinate equation for the arbitrary scalar T and arbitrary vector H. Why call it a scalar T? Scalar is not having any direction and magnitude. Though it is having a direction, but there is no magnitude. So the vector is, this is the arbitrary vector. It may be any direction it can move out. Any direction it can go. I cannot say only you go, heat transfer go in only X direction. It can also go in Z direction. It can also go in Y direction also. Coming to the next definition that I am going to take. So the general three-dimensional conduction equation in Cartesian coordinates. Previously already derived that equation by considering the elemental volume, the delta x, delta y and delta z, and I have shown only in x direction, qx in x direction. After the incremental change in the volume, how the equation can be, equation is partially differentiated, that is ka dt by dx is delta double t by delta x, double x is partially differentiated in the next step, that is qx plus dx. How the heat, the component is going to be changed, that is already shown, and then equation is derived. It is very simple here in general conduction heat equation by using the above equation. See, only coordinate you have to change the above equation. Here what you have to do, what are the coordinates for the Cartesian coordinate? Here x1 is equal to x, x2 is equal to y, x3 is equal to z. You have to substitute in this equation. These are the coordinate. So the vectors are hx is equal to 1, hx1 is equal to, again xy is equal to 1, hz is equal to 1. These coordinates you have to substitute here, and x1, x2, x3. It can be written as x1, x2, x3. Any fashion you can take, and after substituting, you will get back the same equation as I derived previously. It is very simple, and this also holds good for derivation and simplification. So after substituting all these coordinates, you will get this equation. At this, at let square t, it can be written as, and further more simplification you have to do is, at let square t is del square t by del x square plus del square t by del y square plus del square t by del z square, where at let square is del square divided by delta x square plus del square delta y square, and it only the t is taken out, at let square value is written, where this is the value, and with heat generation and with internal energy, change in the internal energy equation can be added and substituted, because it is a previous derivation which I added already, how the internal energy change occurs because of the elemental volume, change in the elemental volume, how the heat energy is going to be stored, and get causes for the change in the internal energy, that also I explained. So using these, you can write the simplified equation can be written like this, at let square t by at let sorry delta square del square t by delta x square plus del square t by del y square, and you can, the whole unit can be written as at let square t. So that is what, if you substitute there, at let square t by plus q dot by k plus is equal to 1 by alpha del t by delta t. This is the controlling differential equation. It can be, now here afterwards, this equation can be written as, this equation I am going to write so that is d square t by dx square plus d square t by dy square plus d square t by dz square is equal to plus q dot by k is equal to rho cp dt by d tau. Instead of t, I can write d tau. This is k. This whole component is unsteady state. It reflects that this whole component is unsteady state condition because time factor is there. It means you differentiate the temperature change with respect to the time. It cannot be a constant. It cannot be steady. It keep on changing. That is why it's an unsteady state component. And with heat generation. Okay. So this can be written as at let square t plus q dot k is equal to 1 by alpha dt by dt or dt small t. So this is the three-dimensional unsteady state with heat generation equation in Cartesian coordinate. Similarly, extend this to cylindrical coordinates. So the general three-dimensional heat conduction equation in cylindrical coordinate system can be visualized by considering the elemental volume of a cylinder. It is at a coordinates other than the elemental coordinates. Dz is the length of the cylinder, and dr is the thickness of the cylinder, and r is the radius from the center of the cylinder. So that you need to specify three dimension. So any object in three dimension, you need three coordinates, that is dz, dr, and phi. That is a one other coordinate. It means d phi, another coordinate is there, because it is a circumferential object. It means circular object. That is why you need to have the angular coordinate also. So these coordinates in the above equation, in cylinder coordinate, again you have to write the coordinate for that. That in, you already studied this in the mathematics. After writing that figure, x1 is the coordinate, that is radius, and x2 is the angle subtended by the elemental volume taken, that is phi. X3 is equal to z, that is thickness or the length of the cylinder. And other the coordinate are the HR1, radius is equal to 1, that is equal to H1. Again, H5, it is R is equal to H2. Again, it is Hz is equal to 1, that is equal to H3. So, wherever possible, all these coordinates can be changed in the equation 2.16 in the cylindrical coordinate system by using this equation. So, I am going to get the coordinates like this. After substituting and simplifying the coordinates, you will get the three-dimensional conduction equation in cylindrical coordinates as Atlet square t. Okay, again you have to write this Atlet, this is equal to Atlet square t is equal to this equation. So substituting all this, what do you get? You will get because of space, I am going to write these coordinates. You can also try and simplify. Finally, the cylindrical coordinate system is dabba square t by dabba. Instead of x square, what I have to write here, r square plus 1 by r dabba t by dabba r plus, this is the first coordinate. It means a one dimensional equation. The second dimension equation is 1 by r square dabba t by dabba phi. Next, plus dabba square t by dabba z square. So this is the equation that I am going to get, that is Atlet square t in cylindrical coordinates. Simply further, you have to simplify. There are three coordinates. One is, three dimension. This is one dimension, this is second dimension, this is third dimension. All the three at the outside, each having possessing its own dimension. And it is in the x direction, this is in y direction, that is in y direction means rotational, and this is z direction. So these three coordinates are required to specify the three dimension, and that I have written there, d phi square. This whole thing is one dimension in a coordinate of radius. So next, go to the next step of the simplification, you will get simple equation you are going to get. I have not added the heat generation. What you have to do is, for simple equation, you have to add plus Q dot K. Can you able to see? Yes, you are going to see. Is equal to 1 by alpha dT by d tau. So this is the three-dimensional heat conduction equation with heat generation unsteady state for cylindrical coordinate system. Okay, three-dimensional heat conduction equation cylindrical object with heat generation with unsteady state. These are the words that you have to use. How do you read this equation? Three-dimensional heat conduction equation with heat generation, but because it is an unsteady state. So if it is not there, it becomes a steady state. This component, if it is not there, this becomes a steady state. If it is not there without heat generation, you can use this. Because you got to solve the heat conduction equation. Another two is that with the variable thermal conductivity and with and without heat generation. With and without means, with means this equation is included here. This component is, this particular factor is included in the equation. If unsteady state is there, that we are going to talk in conduction equation, how the unsteady state equations can be and the situation can be solved in the practically. That I am going to take up. This is the steady state three-dimensional heat conduction equation, cylindrical coordinate with heat generation for a given system. If this component is not there, then it is equated to zero, then it becomes a steady state. Similarly, for cylindrical coordinate, again the same coordinate you have to specify using the the general three-dimensional conduction equation and spherical coordinates. Again, you have to specify the coordinates. X1 is equal to r, x2 is equal to phi, x3 is equal to theta. Both are pi mentioned, no? Yes, there is one more typographical mistake. S3 is theta, and other coordinates are hr is equal to 1, this is equal to h1. Again, it is h phi is equal to r is equal to h2. There is a mistake you have to note down. Instead of h3 is equal to theta, not phi. Okay, again it is h theta is equal to r sin theta is equal to x3. R sin theta is equal to h3. These coordinate to substitute, this coordinate can be substituted wherever h is there, h1, h2, h3 is there, can substitute 1 r and r sin theta. And wherever x1, x2, x3 are there, you can substitute r, x2 is equal to phi, x3 is equal to theta. And then you have to simplify this equation by substituting all these coordinates in the above equation and simplifying this equation. By first you have to understand this the figure, how the spherical object is bounded by the coordinates. This is the dr is the thickness of the hollow sphere. It means r and dr are the radius, and it is visualize the three dimensional object. These are the coordinates required, that is theta is the one direction and phi is the another direction, because object has to revolve around 360 in both the direction, then only it becomes sphere, otherwise it becomes a cylinder. If the phi is not, theta is not there, it becomes a cylinder. So this is the simplified equation that I am going to get. After simplification, you will get three coordinates. So this is the equation. I have made a substitution here. After that, I got simplified, and it become very complex equation to write. Okay, and multiplied by r square with the differential equation, the first term become d by d. It means already control and differential equation I have taken. That is why the delta is reduced to exact differential dt by d square t by dr square, like that I have taken. So this is again you require more some more steps to simplify, and finally I'll get the equation like this. So this is the first order, it means first coordinate, second coordinate, and this is the third coordinate. It means three dimensional equation means you should have, this is the first dimension, second dimension, and third dimension. This is again a general three dimensional heat conduction equation for spherical coordinate. I would like to bring to your kind notice that the only Cartesian coordinate three dimensional equation is asked you to derive. But why I have derived this cylindrical and spherical is that for he has asked the another next model 2 syllabus is there. He has asked to solve the problem of with variable thermal conductivity, without variable thermal conductivity, and also the steady and unsteady state heat conduction equation. In all the configuration is asking with the various different boundary conditions with all the configuration. Then you need this equation help for solving those problems in cylindrical as well as spherical coordinate, because he is asking to specify different boundary conditions of heat conduction, convection, and heat flux condition also. So wherever you miss these derivations and understanding the three dimension, you'll have to learn and practice, then only able to recall. The various books gives the different solution. This is how I have taken from mathematical background, I derived these equation. So I am trying to solve one dimensional basic equation for unsteady state with heat generation. So consider a slab of thickness x, and delta x is the small elemental volume that I have taken with heat generation. Heat generation is the coil, it means whatever the heat generated with respect to the volume of the element. Volume of the element means area of cross section into the thickness of the element, then it gives the volume. So slab with heat generation. So the system in a steady state, a temperature does not change with time. That is, the time is the most important factor to become unsteady state. We are considering the case where the temperature may change with respect to the time is said to be unsteady state, and heat source may be present in the body. If the heat source is present in the body, there is a heat generation. The element of thickness dx is taken for energy balance equation. So the energy balance equation, I am going to write the energy balance equation for this total element. Okay. So the net heat conducted in xyz direction as per unit time, plus the heat generated internally in volume element, that is q dot a into dx, that is a volume element, is equal to the change in the internal energy in the element. So that can be written as qx is the amount of heat conducted in xyz direction, only in x direction. Instead of xyz direction, I can take only in x direction, because single dimension, these two dimensions are not present, because I am going to get it qx I am going to take. And the amount of heat internally generated with the unit volume is q dot into the volume into the is equal to the increase in the internal energy of the volume element, that is rho Cp delta T by dt into dx. This is the volume, this is the mass, mcp delta T I am going to take. That can be written in this different form, plus qx plus dx. Wherever the equation is written, again I am going to get all the three dimensional equation only. Again, see, single dimension with heat generation, if after simplifying this, what is the equation I am going to write? Qx, qs is equal to minus kx dt by dx plus q dot a dx, and mcp, that is rho cp into a dt by dx into dx, where all this incremental qx plus dx is written. Qx is minus ka dt by dx, and dx is a small incremental change in the and what will be the energy change across the small incremental area, incremental volume. Then that is d by dx of minus ka dt by dx into dx. After simplifying this, this is get cancelled with this. Left hand side is get cancelled with right hand side. Only this factor is left out. That can be written as, again it is in the partial differential equation, I am going to write this dou square t by dx square plus q dot k is equal to rho cp k by dou t by dx. The controlling differential equation, if you write again, all delta is going to be, del is going to be changed to d. Why we are going to take that as, there is no incremental change occurring in that. Partially we are not differentiating. This is a partial differential equation. This is the exact differential equation that I am going to write. Finally, if these two components are not there, that is heat generation and change in the internal energy components are there, only this value is left out. Okay, this is the steady state one dimensional heat conduction equation with heat generation. Unsteady state I am writing here, not steady state, unsteady state one dimensional heat conduction equation with heat generation. Unsteady state one dimensional conduction equation with heat generation. Three, you read like this and like this. It means, so this is the, if both two components are not there, is equated to zero, then it is said to be a steady state one dimensional heat conduction equation without heat generation. There is a saying that there is a only one dimension left out, that is del square t by del x square. It can be written as a controlling differential equation for a particular case. Del square t by del x square can be written as d square t by dx square for a particular case. This is called controlling differential equation in controlling differential equation, first order differential. It means a one dimensional conduction equation in rectangular coordinate also, or Cartesian coordinate also you can call, but it is a steady state equation. Okay, and all that exercise is made to calculate the amount of heat transfer for a steady state one dimensional heat conduction equation. Here afterwards, whatever the discussion to going to take place, not with respect to z and y direction, it is only single studies, it means single dimension, that is one dimension with the conduction equation I am going to deal with heat generation or without heat generation. So I am going to take that. So therefore, the one dimensional conduction equation, rectangular coordinate also you can call, Cartesian coordinate also you can say. For a plane wall, how you are going to use this equation, this differential equation, and how we are going to solve a particular problem given for a slab of thickness x or thickness L, you call it as. Suppose you consider the controlling differential equation d square t by dx square is equal to 0. This equation I consider for a slab of thickness L. So earlier you used to take that L as x plus dx you are going to take. So this is what the equation I have right now, t square t by dx square, that's equal to 0. Time is up now. I am going to stop at this point.